Now that you know about search ads and how the Google Ads auction works, it's time to start building your account. In this video, you'll learn how to organize your account with the right hierarchy of campaigns, ad groups, ads, and keywords. Google Ads is organized into three layers: account, campaigns, and ad groups. Let's go over ad groups and campaigns. An ad group lets you organize and target your ads. Each ad group contains one or more ads and a group of keywords that will trigger those ads. Imagine that you sell kids' shoes. You might offer many types of shoes, like sneakers, sandals, and dress shoes. When a customer searches for kids' sneakers, you want your ad to be relevant to that specific search. You wouldn't want to show an ad for kids' dress shoes or even just kids' shoes to someone searching for kids' sneakers. However, if your ad reads, "Velcro sneakers for kids," this would cause your ad to be more relevant to their search, which helps increase your quality score and potential click-through rate. Your ad group structure gives you the ability to be specific and relevant. In one ad group, you'll include all of your sneaker keywords. These keywords will only trigger ads that mention sneakers in their text. You'll also have a sandals ad group with keywords about sandals. These keywords will only trigger ads that mention sandals. Best practice is to have each ad group lead to a relevant landing page. This way, sneaker ads lead to sneaker landing pages, and sandal ads lead to sandal landing pages. For the best user experience, you should always aim for the highest relevance between a customer's search term, the ad that will be triggered, and the landing page that the customer will land on. Ensure that your ad groups are tightly themed based on what you're selling and on how people might search for it. Now that you have an understanding of ad group structure, let's review campaigns. Your campaigns are used to organize your ad groups. They give you a manageable picture of how much you spend on each product or service and how they are performing. Settings like daily budget, geographical targeting, and language targeting are set at the campaign level. Consider these settings when organizing your campaigns. Thinking about our example, the sneakers, sandals, and dress shoes ad groups would likely sit under a shoes campaign. We want these ad groups to be under the same campaign so that you can have a clear view of how shoes sell compared to shirts or pants. Another reason to structure your campaigns like this is if you have a separate budget for shoes, shirts, or pants. An optimal account structure should mirror your website. For example, imagine your website menu is organized by shirts, pants, shoes, onesies, and accessories. These various product categories could be your campaigns. Under each campaign, you'd have ad groups specifying the subtypes of these products. If your website is structured like this, you may also consider building separate campaigns for boys or girls. Each one of these campaigns will then have separate ad groups for products. For example, girls' shoes and girls' shirts, and also boys' shoes and boys' shirts. Both of these account structures work since they match the website structure and the landing pages customers will be directed to. Once you have your first campaign set up, consider creating a dynamic search campaign, which helps you capture all relevant search terms that are not captured by your existing campaigns. This is super valuable since 15% of the searches seen every day are new and can't be predicted. So far, you've learned about generic keywords that refer to the product or service that you're offering. But it's also important to create a campaign with branded keywords. Your brand campaign ensures that your ad shows up when people search for your business name. This campaign is important to your account since people might search your business name once they learn about you. There are many effective ways to organize an account. Find the balance between an account structure that enables relevance between search terms, ads, and landing pages while simultaneously being easy to manage. For example, managing hundreds of campaigns in one account can make management difficult and also isn't necessary, especially when using smart bidding. Creating tightly themed ad groups and campaigns that mirror your website will help you achieve a simpler campaign structure while keeping ads relevant. Now that you know about account organization, it's time to set up keywords in your account.